I saw an article recently that talks about how Jeff Bezos at Amazon has banned PowerPoint at executive meetings. So basically what they're doing is no PowerPoints, no bullets. When someone is coming up with a new topic, as they would do today with a PowerPoint, they are writing a six-page document. At the first 30 minutes of the meeting, everybody reads the six-page document. So can you imagine sitting in a meeting with executives, or any meeting for that matter, and everybody is sitting there consuming it, because no one's going to read it ahead of time probably, right? And everybody spends time to properly consume it, and then they have a discussion about it. And what he talks about is that bullets don't inspire people, but stories do. And so it's about getting more into narrative, away from bullet point death by bullet point, and other organizations. Elon Musk is doing this, Richard Branson is doing this, CEO of Google's doing this. So it seems like a bit of a trend there in storytelling, you know, because I've been talking a lot about storytelling in one of the books, which I'm 10 pages in.
What page are you on now?
10.
Still on 10.
You're on 7.
Had a busy month.
I left it in his house. He read it, and I read the whole thing. He wasn't that impressed. But anyway, so that's that one. The other one I've got.
Well, wait a minute. We're going to go one by one.
One by one. Okay.
Yeah. All right.
You're up, Tom. 127.
You know, I read that article about the Amazon, and what I didn't get from the article was whether it's cut down on meetings. It seems like it would.
It's meant to cut down on
meetings. And I know it's a big transition for
me. It makes the meetings more productive, because you're not sitting there getting hammered over the head with a PowerPoint.
But do you think it's also eliminated some meetings?
I don't know.
Seems like it.
Maybe people don't want to write the six.
Who wants to write the six-page document?
Yeah,
really.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah, dude, that's right. A commitment.
There you go.
It's a commitment.
So, moving right along. If Alexa says it's a good product, it must be, right? I mean, would you make a purchase based on a smart speaker recommendation? Well, it turns out a lot of people do.